game brought an entire nation together again in a time of defeat that seemed unending. One game restored the pride, confidence, and dignity in the U.S. that was slowly breaking. One game marked the greatest upset and underdog story of all time that would change the sports industry forever. This was all made possible with one coach. Herb Brooks left a legacy in sports and American history when he led the USA Olympic hockey team to victory against the Soviet Union, causing the famous Miracle on Ice, the biggest upset in history. Herb Brooks was born in St. Paul, Minnesota on August 5, 1937. Brooks began playing hockey very early on in his life and dreamed of playing professionally. He attended St. Paul Johnson High School and played on their hockey team. Brooks was a two-year varsity player and played in the state tournament both years. When Brooks was a senior, his team beat Minneapolis Southwest 3-1 for the state title in 1955. Brooks described his high school championship as being one of the best moments of his career. After high school, Brooks decided to play college hockey for the University of Minnesota. During his college career, he was known as the fastest skater in college hockey. In 1960, Herb Brooks tried out for the Olympic hockey team and made it, but was unfortunately the last man cut before the Olympic tournament. After he was cut, the team went on to beat the Soviets and win a gold medal. As Brooks watched his own team win the gold medal while at home, his father said, "Looks like the coach made the right choice." Many say this is what pushed him to become a coach. Brooks did not give up and decided to try out for the 1964 and 68 team. He made the team both years, but they unfortunately never won a medal. Shortly after playing for the 64 and 68 team, his career came to a close. After Brooks tried out a few different office jobs, he found that coaching hockey was where he needed to be. Brooks received a job coaching the freshmen at the University of Minnesota, and gradually earned the head coach position in 1972. He eventually led the last place Minnesota team to an NCAA title just 2 years later, the first of three he would win coaching this team. While coaching the Minnesota Gophers, Brooks formed a record of 175 wins, 100 losses, and 20 ties. It was clear that Brooks really respected his players while coaching Minnesota. He once said, "They were a very competitive and mentally tough team." In 1979, Herb Brooks decided to leave the University of Minnesota hockey team and attempt at becoming the Olympic coach of the 1980 team. A year after his interview with a committee, Brooks received the coaching job. Quicker than he thought they'd come, the tryouts began. 68 players participated in a 10-day-long tournament as a tryout. At the end of this tournament, the team was chosen. Brooks picked a team consisting of 26 players. 10 months before the Olympics, the team had 60 exhibition games to prepare for the big games in Lake Placid. During this time, Brooks developed them into a team. He also had to decide which 6 players to cut off the team in order to get the required 20 players for the Olympics. Brooks also developed a new coaching style that most did not agree with. His new style was one players had never really used in the U.S. This strategy used an aggressive style of defense before the opponent could organize an attack with a puck possession strategy. It required creativity and teamwork. But his most famous strategy of coaching was the use of one word, fear. He drove the team in a way that was cold and ruthless. He used many sayings and expressions to push and motivate his players. One he would regularly use was, "You people are playing worse every day, and right now you're playing like the middle of next month." Brooks constantly played mind games with the players, pushing them to the limit. There were many famous events that brought the team to be the successful players they were. During an exhibition game against the Norwegian team, Brooks was not happy with the way they were playing. They were unfocused and not playing like they should. Brooks was so irritated with them, he marched the players onto the ice and made them skate suicides as the crowd slowly emptied out of the arena. As the players were on the edge of collapse, Brooks finally let them go. His purpose of the skating suicides was evident: work or go home. Another famous incident came during the Olympic game opener against Sweden. The U.S. team was obviously not playing to the best of their ability, as they fell behind 1-0 after the first period. In the locker room, Rob McClanahan began taking off his equipment as he had been hurt during the game. As Coach Brooks walked in, he snapped at the sight of McClanahan taking off his equipment. Brooks flipped out on McClanahan, calling him a gutless choker and many other names that set him off in front of the entire team. McClanahan was so angry he began to chase after Brooks, yelling out, "I'll show you," while Mike Iruzioni pulled Brooks out of the locker room. Brooks did not plan this, but he needed to motivate his players somehow, and this was the perfect opportunity, and it worked. The team came together angry at the coach, and McClanahan played great the rest of the game and tournament. This was a reoccurring technique of Coach Brooks. He established this technique because the team was made up of rivals from the East and Midwest teams. He wanted to make them hate him more than they hated each other. They were the only team to go undefeated in the tournament, playing Sweden, Czech, Norway, Romania, and West Germany before the two big games against the Soviets and Finland. There were many major events leading up to the Soviets game on February 22, 1980 that caused America's morale to decrease day after day. On November 4, 1979, more than 60 Americans were taken hostage from the U.S. Embassy in Tehran. This hostage crisis was said to have absorbed more concentration from American officials and had more coverage in the press than any other event since World War II. Only a month later, in December 1979, the Soviets invaded Afghanistan. This invasion brought a lot of stress to America. President Carter, as well as many other ordinary citizens, were worried this was the Soviets' continued attempt of a military takeover. It was clear the U.S. needed a confidence booster. The game against the Soviets on February 22nd did just that. As the players hit the ice, they had no idea this would be more than just a hockey game. The Soviets were the first to score, scaring the USA team into thinking this would be a repeat of the previous 10-3 loss to this team a few weeks before. Fortunately, Buzz Schneider tied it up 1-1. Unfazed, the Soviets then went ahead 2-1, thinking they would take the lead after the first period. Because of the genius act of Coach Brooks, Mark Johnson sneaked in with seconds remaining, scoring the surprising goal to tie it up. Back on the ice again, the Soviets had pulled ahead, but to the Soviets' surprise again, Mark Johnson tied it up at 3. Then came the most famous goal of the game that would once again pull all of America together again. Mike Iruzioni scored the fourth and final goal with 10 minutes left, the first lead the U.S. would take. The USA team and the nation grew stronger and more confident as the time wound down. Cheers, yells, and screams of joy were heard across the nation as a miracle had just been created on February 22, 1980. Herb Brooks wanted this win from the moment he was cut from the Olympic team in 1960, and the U.S. wanted it as well. The effect this win had on the country was unimaginable, and the win against Finland 2 days after in the championship added to the excitement and pride of the nation. Even if his coaching strategy didn't show it, Brooks loved every one of his players. Unfortunately, Brooks passed away in 2003, but his legacy continues to live on. Herb Brooks did much more for the nation than win a gold medal in the Olympic tournament. He was able to bring together 20 individual hockey amateurs and form them into a team of close-knit, talented players that won as a team. Herb Brooks not only brought together a group of individuals, but he brought an entire nation together in one game that will always be remembered as the miracle on ice.